If you could just say your name so I have it.
Dave Christian.
Okay. And what brings you to Duluth?
I'm here to take part in this chamber event. And, you know, the sacrifice to great for greatness. And I was fortunate enough to be a member of that 1980 Olympic hockey team. And so it's a pleasure to be up here with, I'm sure, lots of hockey fans and lots of people that remember that 1980 gold medal moment.
And how are you involved in hockey these days?
Pretty much as a parent. I've got a daughter that's playing college hockey. I had a son that played college hockey, and try to stay in. He's now coaching, so I go and watch his team play and spend some time coaching. But now that the kids are grown and out of the house, I just as a spectator now.
Are we getting close to the Olympics right now? What kind of memories does that bring back every time?
Every 4 years, starting about now, it's just a flood of great memories, of great teammates, an experience that I never get tired of talking about. And of course, you know, it wasn't so much, you know, the success and winning the gold medal was, you know, just kind of icing on the cake. It was the experience of the whole year and fantastic teammates and all the things that I learned in that adventure and that journey leading up to Lake Placid.
Do you ever get tired of the questions they keep asking about the miracle on ice?
No, hopefully I never do, but to this point, no, I don't get tired of talking about it. It was such a big, great moment and highlight of my hockey career that I hope I don't ever get tired of it.
What question that people are always asking questions, what question don't they ask you that you wish they would ask you?
Oh my goodness, I think I've been asked just about everything. I can't, really nothing comes to mind. Did you have fun during that year? And to which the answer would be, yeah, we had a lot of fun and probably at times did things that won't ever be shared other than just with the members of the team.
Talk about the significance of that game, I guess the time with the U.S. and the Soviets and whatever else was going on at that time.
Well, there was so much significance placed on it, you know, as a symbol of, you know, our way of life was better than their way of life, and you know, the, you know, democracy and capitalism versus communism, and there's so many things, but to the guys on that team, it was a great challenge. It was just an athletic event. It was just a game. And, you know, we take a lot of pride in the fact that the country, there was kind of a rallying point for the country as a whole with all the different things and issues that we were going through at the time. But, you know, for us as players, it was a great challenge just the game itself.
Going through that experience, what has it really done for you for the rest of your life in the last 30 years now?
Oh, I guess, what could I say? I think in the fact that in anything you do, our coach Herb Brooks instilled in us that regardless of what we went on to do, that, you know, we had to bring the lunch pail, we had to put the hard hat on, and regardless of what you're doing, you better show up every day and do your best.
I still remember the day because I was at St. Cloud State and I was in my dormitory, hopped in the elevator, and I got stuck in the elevator for how many hours.
Oh my goodness.
That's why I remember February 22nd.
Oh wow, now that's a story that I have not heard before.
Yes.
Thank you for sharing that. That's excellent.
Anyway, thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you.